talked about Leofan's four lessons. The fourth lesson. The fourth lesson is the benefit of the virtue of humility. You want to change your destiny, change all your bad ways and do all that is good. But you want to keep your virtues, you have to stay humble. Humbleness is a virtue. If you can stay humble, then you will keep your prosperity and your good fortune. This lesson, we're gonna learn how to be humble based on what Liao Fan's experience. In the book of I Ching, he actually told us a lot of goodness of being humble. The laws of heaven takes from the arrogant and benefit the humble. The heaven likes people that are humble. They take away from the people that are arrogant and give to people that are humble. So we want to stay down to earth and respectful and not to boast about ourselves, our accomplishment or anything that we have. Heavens will be happy. Okay, and the second is the law of earth bring flowing water from areas that are full to those that are lower as it passes by. When you're too high, that means the water is full. The earth always brings the water down to the people that are humble. That means at lower places. The earth will benefit you and bring the water to you because you're being humble. Okay, so that's the earth. The third is the law of spirits bring harm to those who are arrogant and good fortune to those who are modest. So that the heavenly beings, the spirits, they actually can see our heart and see our every action. If you're arrogant, they actually will hurt you. You have bad luck, a bad thing will happen to you for no reason. But if you stay humble and modest, you will get a lot of good fortune from the spirits. The spirit will help you out because you've been very modest. And lastly, the laws of people despise those who are arrogant and prefer those who are modest. Even in our world, people don't like to hang out with people that are very arrogant. You're always bragging about yourself. Nobody wants to be your friend because you're so full of yourself. Even the laws of people despise those who are arrogant and prefer those who are modest. So the heaven, the earth, the spirit, people, they all prefer people that are humble and don't like those that are very arrogant. Their arrogance invites disaster, humility gains benefit. If you're arrogant, you invite trouble for yourself. Okay, if you're humble, then you gain a lot of good things. Good things will happen to you naturally. Okay, so Liao Fan now tells about a couple of his friends at his time. There was a person named Jing Yu Ding. He went to take the imperial exam with Liao Fan. So there were 10 of them all went to take the test. Out of the 10 of them, there's the youngest, who is Jing Yu. He's the only one that's very modest. When people insult him, slander him, he doesn't talk back. He just accepts whatever the accusation. Liao Fan said, this person will be the only person that will pass the test. And sure enough, out of that 10, Jing Yu was the only one passed the test that year. Then the second person, Liao Fan's childhood friend, Kai Zifeng. Now they're older. Liao Fan said, when Kai Zifeng was young, he was very, very arrogant. But now he's grown up, he's actually became very mild, humble, and respectful. One of his friends always liked to accuse him and scold him of all his mistakes. But he never talks back. He just calmly accepts all the accusations and never says anything. So Liao Fan said he will be the person that will pass the test. And sure enough, Kai Zi passed the test that year. There was a third person, he passed the preliminary test when he was very young. But for the life of him, he couldn't pass the second level. He wrote very good essay, but he still couldn't pass. And one year, his dad went to a different province to take a government post, so he went with his dad. Over there, there's a very famous scholar. So he brought his essay to show the scholar. The scholar actually destroyed and made a lot of correction on his essay. He respectfully accepted all the correction and he made all the changes. And sure enough, that year, he passed the exam, not the imperial exam. Okay, so that's the third person. And then Liao Fan talks about a fourth person. He has really good essays, but he's very arrogant. So that year, the test result came out. He didn't pass the test. And he started screaming. He said, the examiner must be blind, couldn't see my real talent. He started screaming and yelling. And there was a Taoist monk walked by and started laughing at him. He redirected his anger toward the monk. He said, why are you laughing? The monk said, you must not write very good essays. And then he said, how do you know? You haven't even seen my essay. And the monk says, in order to write good essay, you must have good temperament. You must have a peaceful mind. With your anger, you must not write very good essay. And then he said, how can I start passing the test? What can I do to change my life? The monk says, you know, from now on, you should be humble. Change your way. Cultivate good deeds. You will pass the exam. Then he said, how can I do good deeds? I'm just a poor student. The monk says, you know, being humble, that doesn't cost any money. That is hidden virtue. That is already very good deed. So from that day on, he controlled himself, had great discipline. And so he did that for 3 years. One night, he had a dream and he went to the underworld. He saw someone with this booklet. This booklet had a lot of names and some blank spaces. He asked the person next to him, what is this book? He said, oh, this book is all the people that's going to pass the imperial exam this year. The blank spaces are people that didn't do good deeds, so their name has been erased. You, on the other hand, these 3 years, you have been doing really well, so your name is going to fill one of the blank spaces. And sure enough, after he had that dream, he passed the exam that year. So all these people, by being humble, actually attract good fortune. But you don't want good fortune and success just for yourself. It's better that you want it for the entire world. You want to benefit the whole society. Mencius told an emperor that it's great that you love music, but you loving music is just a personal pleasure. If you can put this love of music for all the people in your country and make them happy as well, your whole country will be prosperous. So a humble person will always improve themselves. So this lifetime, if you stay humble and virtuous, you will do a lot more and you can benefit the entire world. That's it for the Liao Fans 4 lesson. And next time we'll talk about something else. Okay, so thank you for listening. Omitofo.